Well, welcome to America, amigo.
You are fast, Ricky Bobby.
But I am faster.
All right, you let go of me, you Formula One jazz nut job.
Like the frightened baby chipmunk, you are scared by anything that is different. I will let you go, Ricky. But first, I want you to say,
I love crepes.
Don't you say it, Ricky. These colors don't run.
I'm not gonna say it.
Good.
Hey, look, Frenchie, I thought about it. So why don't you go ahead and break my arm?
I do not want to break your arm, Monsieur Bobby, but I am a man of my word.
Here's the deal. He's not gonna break it, because I'm gonna slip out of it right now. Houdini!
Whoa! Ah, keep down, you little punky.
Someone might as well give me a beer while I'm down here.
But you have forced me to do this. You are now mocking me and making me look ridiculous. Just say, I love crepes.
You know, just to put this in there, I had a whole mess of crepes this morning. They're just like pancakes, maybe even better.
Wait, are they the really thin pancakes?
Yeah.
Yes, they are. They are really thin pancakes. It's just a French word for them.
Oh, my God, I love
whatever
those.
Whatever syrups you want on them and stuff. I'm just saying, think about it.
They come with cheese sometimes?
Yes, of course, a fromage crepe.
Well, why didn't someone yell that right away?
Do you know what's in the crepe Suzette?
Oh, I love the crepe Suzette.
With the sugar and
the sugar
lemon juice.
And the lemon juice, sure.
Come on,
yeah. I wish I could crawl into one of those right now.
Eat my way out from the inside.
Oh, it's how tasty.
Oh, man, you know, either way this goes down, can we go get some after we're done?
Absolutely, we're going to do that.
Bon, so what if you just said, I love really thin pancakes? That is a fair compromise, no?
That is a fair compromise.
That's very fair, actually.
Okay. Now, because then everyone will know I really meant crepes.
That's actually a pretty good compromise right there.
Why do you want me to break your arm so badly?
You don't understand. You don't understand because you don't understand liberty. You don't understand freedom. So you put a crack in my arm like the crack in the Liberty Bell. You hear me?
Hey, it's just between you and me, okay?
Yeah.
I mean, forget all these other guys, but he did give you a pretty decent out.
But it's your call.
What do you think?
Don't say it.
Yeah, I'm not gonna say it.
Nope. Break it, Pepe Le Pew!
As you wish.
He actually did it!
All right, you did it.
Ah, back off!
No, you did not.
Your injury is one of ignorance and pride. Au revoir.
Hold it right there, Mr. Fancy Pants Foreigner. You just broke my bro's arm. Now you're about to get tasered.
Say hello to Dr. Watts.
Good girl.
I need you all to step away from my driver.
The hell are you talking about my driver? What are you doing with a gun in here anyway?
Don't you worry about my gun, Ricky. Jean Girard is my new boy at Dennett Racing. He's here to win us an overall points championship, something you apparently have no interest in doing. He's gonna usher in a new era for us.
Mr. Dennett, with all due respect, and remember, I'm saying with all due respect, that idea ain't worth a velvet painting of a whale and a dolphin getting it on.
That's good. That's good fun. That's good fun, Ricky. But it doesn't bother me anymore because Jean is the future, Ricky the past.
So Jean, introduce me to your new teammates.
Everybody, this is my husband, Gregory.
See what's the track?
Did he just say husband?
Sweet Lord. Dennett hired a gay Frenchman as your teammate.
Room's starting to spin real fast. Because of gayness. Cal, I love you.
Ricky! Oh. Ricky! Oh!